started writing code in mind without knowing the entire feature of the system, and that used to create lots and lots of bugs or deviation into your testing phase. When TDD came into the picture, you know, there are many systems I have seen which went bug free. Yes, establishing TDD initial part of your project is a costly affair. People may think that is going to take lots of time, but end of the project, when you go into testing cycle, you will not find many bugs. If you look at extreme programming, you know, extreme programming says we don't want testers. It's just about developers, and that to focus on unit testing. Yes, they are costly systems, but you are putting more money at one side, but saving your money at another side. So the entire cost of the project will be balanced. These systems, again, these are not meant for simple kind of project, you know, which are very straightforward and the entire requirements are very much clear. These kind of methods are more suitable for the project where the requirements are very vague or requirements are very tough. You don't have much algorithm, much existing code. Even at the Google, you are not finding how to code up the system. These are more suitable for R&D kind of projects where you have to come up with different aspects of the system. They are more suitable.
When a requirement is captured, say from the final stakeholder, so at that point, nobody thinks of involving an engineer who's